The explosive revelations in former Maharashtra top cop Rakesh Maria's book have stirred a hornet's nest politically as Maria exposed Pakistan's Hindu terror bogie. The 10 Pakistani terrorists carried fake identity cards with Hindu names. They tied a kalava, that sacred thread, on their wrists, all very carefully planned by Pakistan's ISI to show that 2611 was a Hindu terror attack. The BJP has now come out all guns blazing, attacking the Congress for floating that Hindu terror bogie. Divesh Singh brings you a top story tonight. Pakistan had tried to pass off 2611 Mumbai terror attacks as Hindu terror, writes former Maharashtra top cop Rakesh Maria. Giving details of investigations carried out by the Mumbai police and the interrogation of Pakistani terrorist Ajmal Amir Kasab, Maria exposes Pakistan's Hindu terror plot. He writes, their photographs were clicked to make fake identity cards to pass them off as Indian Hindus. Maria then goes on to write, to complete the Hindu impersonation, they were instructed not to forget tying the red sacred thread around their wrists before landing. Ajmal Amir Kasab carried the identity card of Samir Dinesh Chaudhary, ostensibly a student of Arunodai Degree College and a resident of Bengaluru. The revelation has reignited a political war, giving the BJP an opportunity to target the Congress.
Maria ji ne isse baatein abhi kyun boli? Jab wo police commissioner the tab unhone isse baatein bolni chahiye. Main ninda karta hu Congress ka aur sabhi un logo ka jo Hindu terror ke jhoote aaropon pe ek nayi desh mein gumrah karne ki us samay koshish ki thi Congress ne.
The BJP took on Congress leaders and former Madhya Pradesh Chief Minister Digvijay Singh for releasing a book titled 2611, an RSS conspiracy.
Certain pseudo-intellectuals have still tried to project Mumbai incident as an incident of Hindu terror. They even published a book, RSS Ki Sajish, and that book was sponsored and supported by certain eminent Congress leaders. The conspiracy was hatched by ISI. It was sought to be fulfilled by certain Indian groups and Indian pseudo-intellectuals, and they got support from certain Congress leaders.
The revelation led to a war of words between political parties.
हिंदू धर्म वाले आतंकवादी पकड़े गए हैं सब संघ के कार्यकर्ता रहे हैं किसी न किसी महात्मा गांधी की हत्या करने वाला व्यक्ति भी नाथूराम गोडसे आरएसएस में रहे हैं तो ये विचारधारा जो है नफरत फैलाती है नफरत से हिंसा पैदा होती
है देयर इज अ रिसेंटली अनकवर्ड फिनोमिनन ऑफ सैफ्रन टेररिज्म दैट हैज बीन इंप्लिकेटेड इन मेनी बॉम्ब ब्लास्ट ऑफ द पास्ट.
Maria writes, if Kasab had died as Samir, Pakistan's plans would have succeeded and there would have been a headline that Hindu terrorists had attacked Mumbai. With Divesh in Mumbai, Bureau Report, India Today. Let's get straight to the point. Joining me on the show, Sambit Patra, BJP leader and national spokesperson, Brigadier Govind Singh Sisodia, former DIG of the National Security Guard. He led the NSG operations during 2611. Chetan Singh is a political analyst who will give us the Congress Party perspective. A. Khan was a part of the anti-terror squad of the Maharashtra police. And Sambit Patra, Rakesh Maria has revealed Pakistan's Hindu terror plot. Why is the BJP today targeting the Congress Party?
See, in fact, these are nefarious conspiracies which have come to the fore thanks to Rakesh Maria, the former top cop of Maharashtra. The issue is, the dream of Pakistan was to paint a picture against the Hindus in India, and that is quite understandable that Pakistan would do this. Pakistan is a failed state. But the irony is, there was a political party in India, and astonishingly, the Congress Party under the UPA, it was trying to float the same agenda in India. I mean, the issue was, just imagine Mr. Digvijay Singh, then a top leader of the Congress Party, in fact, releasing using a book, 2611 RSS ki Sajish, 2611 A Plot of Hindus by Mr. Burney. And that was released then and there in Mumbai while we had the terrorist attack. And remember, Mr. P. Chidambaram, a home minister, while addressing the top cops of the country in New Delhi, around that time, 2010 to be precise, comes out with a theory that we have to be wary of saffron terror because the new concept of saffron terror had come. And remember, I was a young spokesperson then on some Jhota blast. We were discussing about Arif Kasmani, who was pinpointed towards by the treasury benches of the United States of America.
Okay.
Despite all that, suddenly the whole thing changes to Hindu terror plot.
Let me take this to Chetan Singh. Chetan Singh, is it time for SS ki sazish when there was open and shut evidence of Pakistan's involvement in 2611 on the night of the attack, sir?
See, like, we have also seen the version of Juhi Karkare, who is the daughter of Martin Hemant Karkare. We know categorically. On the top of it, see, like, you look at, you know, if you're going to go behind the scene, we will understand that what has happened. The Malegaon blast has taken place, Ajmer Sharif stuff has taken place, Samjhota Express stuff has taken place. So what, you know, keeping all these scenarios and episode in consideration, Pakistan has played with emotions. Therefore, he wanted
to... So, Digvijay Singh will peddle Pakistan's agenda.
Stuff and all.
If Pakistan is saying 2611, if Pakistan is trying to put a kalava on Pakistani terrorists, Indians will say that 2611 was RSS ki saazish. No, I just want to understand from you. Sir, I want to understand from you. Ajmal Amir Kasab was RSS.
Gaurav, I have not eaten the dal of RSS camp first. So therefore, I am
so
not going to
pull
the line of RSS.
Police, Rakesh Maria,
second most important
NIA
point out here
have
is
all eaten,
no, no,
have all eaten
on.
RSS
Pakistan,
ki dal
it's a rogue
by
state,
proving
state,
that Pakistan
no
was involved in 2611.
And you see,
Federal Bureau of Investigation has eaten RSS ki dal.
No.
David Coleman Headley was exposed in FBI Federal Court in Chicago. David Coleman Headley.
Gaurav, if
FBI ne RSS ki dal khai.
See, first, all right, Gaurav, just give me 20 seconds. Give me 20 seconds. 20 seconds, I'm going to make it water and milk absolutely separate. First, we need to understand here what exactly has happened. 2611, now we are in 2020. 9 years after this revelations comes up. Why? Because these bureaucrats and these senior officers, police officers, and all these officers, you know, when they are in the service, they enjoy themselves the most. The moment they come out of it, then they come up with these kind of revelations. And now you see, you know, this is about the national security. This is about the integrity. And what is happening now, he's coming up with the revelation. It's a matter of serious concern that why he has taken so many years. He would have divulged this particular fact.
You've come
to
this debate very ill prepared, but anyway.
Second most important point out here.
Sambit Patra wants to respond to you. You should have read the charge sheet of 2611.
Second most.
You should have read the charge sheet of 2611. But anyway, Sambit Patra wants to respond to you before I bring in my other guests.
I have read it thoroughly.
Chetan sir.
I have read it thoroughly.
Please allow me to speak as well, Chetan sir.
I have read for. And now you see, they just want to dwell in the past. Like Sambit Patra, how passionately he talks about Pakistan. We have seen that when the Pathankot attack has taken place, they have invited ISI there.
Good Lord.
Okay.
Fair enough. I believe we should not deviate from here. Number one, as far as.
What? Oh, God. This is very much evident. Who has gone down to Pakistan to eat biryani?
Courteous debate,
we
sir.
All know that. Why? What was the need?
Okay,
you
sir,
look,
as per
no
you, 2611
no
was RSS ki saazish. As per you, the Hindus were the one who were responsible for 2611. Please allow me to keep forth my suggestion over here. My
point is, very much evident out here.
One by one. Sir, you made your point. Sambit Patra wants to rebut. I'll bring in my other guest. Sambit Patra, go on.
See, first and foremost, as for Mr. Maria's book is concerned, it's not that it has been said for the first time. It may be coming from Mr. Maria for the first time, but these conspiracies of Pakistan had been known back then as well. Because the Kalava, a sacred Hindu thread that is tied around the hand, in fact, the right wrist, was tied around Kashab and the other nine who, in fact, were killed.
Yes.
Thanks to Tukaram Omle, I mean, I pray for his soul tonight, because he was the man who caught Kashab alive. And in fact, that's the reason as to why we are having a structured debate today. Yes. Otherwise, thanks to the UPA, they would have proved that this is a Hindu terror. And I Samir object Patra to UPA has, because of the fact that in extension to the dream of Pakistan, they were acting as if they were fulfilling the unfulfilled dream of Pakistan. Why should Mr. Chetan be in the middle of it?
Let me take this to A. Khan.
These entire circumstances,
Mr. Khan, is there unimpeachable evidence, Mr. Khan? Is there unimpeachable evidence that 2611 was a Pakistani terror plot and that information was available on the same night because of that brave assistant sub-inspector of the Mumbai police, Tukaram Ombale, who made the supreme sacrifice of his life but caught Kasab alive? Mr. Khan. I'll take a moment. I'll re-establish that link. Brigadier Sisodia, during the operations itself, did you have information that you were dealing with Pakistani terrorists? What do you make of the Pakistani plot to show this as Hindu terror? Brigadier Sisodia.
There was no doubt that it was Pakistan's action. And if you see when these terrorists were killed, Oblik Kasa was captured, they had a red thread on their hand and they had the identity card with that certain Indian name. So they had covered it in case they are caught initially. They don't divulge that they were the Pakistanis. Firstly. Secondly, till Ajmal Kasab opened up, Pakistan was denying that they were not Pakistanis. Then they accepted. Thirdly, they had a backup plan that in case they are caught, they'll be saying that they are the Pakistanis. In case their body, they are not Pakistanis, if their body is found, they are Hindus. That is a cover-up plan. Maybe, probably, in case Ajmal Kasab had died, they would have put their picture somewhere on the internet or in the media that they were the Hindus, they were not the Pakistanis because of the red thread and various things which they were carrying. So it was Pakistan's agenda to make it a Hindu terror in case this operation failed, in a sense that everybody dies and nobody is identified. That was their plan.
Yes.
But for our good luck and may the soul of Tukaram
Umble sacrifice.
And yes. The way he sacrificed his life, and we were able to capture Ajmal Kasab. And I spoke to Ajmal Kasab on certain issues. I spoke to him, and he was very clear on certain issues that they had come to spread terror, they had spread to kill the people and to die. He was very clear that they had come to die and not to go back. So that if he was not captured, the thing would have said that it was definitely a Hindu
terror.
Right.
And Chetan Singh, admit it or tell me, was it not a mistake? Prominent people in our country saying 26/11 RSS ki saazish. Pakistan ka agenda hai. Hamare log bhi keh rahe hain 26/11 RSS ki saazish.
Look,
with facts in public domain, sir, apne dil par haath rakke sach boliye aaj. Ek Bharatiya hone ke naate aaj ek bar sach bolkar dikhaiye. Was there evidence that this was a Pakistani terror attack? Was it a mistake?
Gaurav, call it RSS? Mera haath hamesha dil pe rehta hai, samvidhan pe rehta hai aur Geeta pe rehta hai, hamesha. Dusra, we need to understand here categorically, as he has mentioned, that in the prison, the terrorist organization, behind the scene people, these sleeper cells, they were given the task to eliminate Kasab. Now this is getting revealed now. Why all these things have not got revealed at that given point of time?
Sir, after 9 years. Sir, I was in that Chicago
so what I'm trying to say,
when
it
David
is just
Coleman Headley gave information
to,
that 2611 was plotted in Pakistan.
Look,
Hafiz Saeed plotted it. Abu Jindal was present in that Karachi control room. It was known.
It is very much known.
So was it a mistake to say it is RSS
to protect Pakistan? Nobody
was it a mistake? Was that playing into Pakistan's hands?
No. See, again, I'm telling you, Gaurav, we have seen the three sequence. You know what has happened? Samjhota Express, Malegaon, and
Samjhota Express.
So
you raised Samjhota
Pakistan,
Express.
ISI, or Jaish-e Mohammed, all these terrorist groups, they have taken the advantage. They have taken the advantage.
You raised Samjhota Express.
And therefore, they have sent these people with that kind of intent. However, our agencies are competent. They're competent enough. They
okay, Sambit Patra wants to respond to you. My only request to both our guests is, please listen to each other.
Out here that
please listen to each other and let truth come out.
People, why he has not taken so much of, why he is taking so much of 9 years of time?
Can I speak, please? Sambit Patra wants to respond. My request to Chetan Singh is to keep quiet while he responds.
See, we have to see the sequence. We had one Mr. P. Chidambaram saying that saffron terror, we have to be wary of saffron terror. Then we have Rahul Gandhi prior to that. In fact, the cables, if you would remember, the US leaked cables, the WikiLeaks, okay, in which he addresses to Timothy Roger, I mean the ambassador of US, and says that we have to be careful about saffron terror. We have to be wary of saffron terror more than the LET. And then we had in 2013, the then home minister of the country, Mr. Sushil Kumar Sinde, saying that RSS and BJP run terror camps, and that's why we have the presence of Hindu terrorism in India. So all this, it's a gamut full of the idea of the Congress party where they are trying to project the Hindus as terrorists. Number one, what I'm intrigued today by the revelations of Mr. Maria is that the photographs, despite the fact that the Mumbai police did not want these Kalava photographs and the photograph of Kasab to come out to the public domain, the central agencies, what is written in the book, let me speak today, is that the central agencies somehow leaked these photographs. I mean, the central agency falls under the central government then. I'm really intrigued, and I want an answer from the supporter of the Congress party as to why the Congress went to the extent of releasing the photograph of Kasab with Kalava when the Mumbai police did not want this to come out.
Without interruption, you spoke. Without interruption, you speak, sir.
See, Gaurav, first.
Go on, Mr. Chetan Singh.
Gaurav, we have seen that what is happening now, state after state, these guys are losing. And because of these dead narratives, which they are coming up with, they are trying to peddle it, it's not working for them anymore. People are not concerned about all these things which they are trying to reveal it. People are more concerned about our agencies. They have a confidence and they know that our agencies are competent enough. However, if the agencies are going to be compromised, what is going to happen, we all know. And what we have seen it
so
in the recent past, in the
garden judges, being
we have seen the CBI director changing overnight. But when it comes down to this specific, when it comes down to the specific point and the book, we all know Samit Patraji is never going to buy his book. On the top of it, after 2 months, he need not to buy this book. What because after 2 months, he's going to find this book in his Daryaganj, where he can buy some churan or moongfali or paan. Neither they have any kind of literature in it, nor they have got any substance. And after 9 years,
that is all I can submit to you. This is a grave issue of national security.
No, it's not.
And let me bring in Brigadier Sisodia while I try and reconnect with Mr. Khan. Mr. Khan, if you can hear me, did the police know this was a Pakistani terror plot during the terror attack of 26/11? And in your appreciation, sir, if it is painted as an RSS ki saazish, does that weaken the case subsequently?
Gaurav, you're asking me?
Yes, Mr. Khan.
I don't think the police were taken in by any such RSS ki saazish or anything of that sort. The police knew very well that it was a Pakistani terror attack. You know, the ISI as a malicious organization is definitely going to try and project it's a Hindu attack or whatever attack they want to show. But I don't think for a moment the police, after that, what we are trying, what I'm a little surprised is that Rakesh Maria, of course, is trying to sell his book by revealing sensational facts, which I don't know how he came to know. He was sitting in the control room at that time.
Okay.
But by bringing out these sensational facts at this stage, I don't understand what is the purpose of the whole dialogue. Whether it was Pakistan tried to show or ISI tried to show it was a Hindu plot, no one in the police force ever got taken in by that.
No, but join the dots, Brigadier Sisodia.
Did a magnificent
David
job,
Coleman Headley so is a Pakistani and American.
And no one ever thought. No one ever thought it was a Hindu plot.
And yet we had political leaders and big political leaders saying 26/11 was an RSS ki saazish.
Always tried to do it.
You know, does that weaken India's, if you're trying to put together a case, like for example, Samjhota, India put together a solid case saying it was Lashkar-e-Taiba and Arif Kashmani, and suddenly after a couple of years, there is a 360 degree turn, Hindu terror is brought in, and that case then falls flat in a court of law. That case falls flat. It collapses in a court of law. Hindu terror case. But let me once again bring in Brigadier Sisodia. Brigadier Sisodia, what does this show of Pakistan's planning. David Coleman Headley bought the Kalava from Siddhi Vinayak Mandir, and this information was given to the Federal Bureau of Investigation in a Chicago courthouse. Point one. Point two, Hindu names and identity cards. Point three, as the BJP spokesperson and leader Sambit Patra points out, senior Congress leaders have been quoted in WikiLeaks cable as saying Hindu terror is more dangerous than Lashkar-e-Taiba.
Rahul Gandhi.
I'll tell you, the next day it was very clear that it was Pakistan's hand, because next day morning when one mobile was caught,
intercept started,
and it was very clear that the information was coming from Pakistan and it is controlled by Pakistan. There is no doubt about it. Next day picture was absolutely clear. Secondly, Mr. Rakesh Maria was in complete picture, because when we landed at Mumbai, I had first briefing by Mr. Rakesh Maria, and he was very clear that what was happening, where he was happening, and he briefed us very well. So he was in picture, there's no doubt about it. And thirdly, these people behave, trying to show that they were Hindus, that was too easy accessibility through the sea, or in case they were checked anywhere for the identity card, they could prove it. And third, I said that the Pakistan might have thought of plan B, in case they are killed and identity is not revealed and Pakistan is not blamed. So they'll be shown as Pakistanis, and the world would be, as Indian, and the whole world would have been told by Pakistan that these were the Hindu, these are the identities,
yes,
these are the signs of threat. And to my mind, to tell you frankly, there's no political color to it. There's no political color to it. Absolutely clear from the day one, it was
okay.
Pakistan involved. And
Sambit Patra.
FBI and other agencies also said next
absolutely
day.
Absolutely. And Sambit Patra, Chetan Singh, Mr. Khan, Brigadier Sisodia, everyone needs to be on the same page. We're dealing with Pakistan state-sponsored terror. We cannot afford to be useful idiots of Pakistanis, Sambit Patra.
See, as far as two experts on your panel are concerned, both of them are conquering. They're conquering to the fact that it was a Pakistani design and it was known well before. I mean, immediately the next day,
yes,
the Pakistan's design was known. The irony is, despite knowing Pakistan's design, the then government ministers and top knots, you know, like
yes,
Mr. Digvijay Singh, they were peddling something which I would say was providing oxygen to Pakistan, number one. Number two, let me also remind you of one incident which we have forgotten in this debate, of Mr. Digvijay Singh categorically coming out and saying that just two hours before death, Mr. Hemant Karkare had called him and said that his life was in danger because he was probing the Malagaon blast. And there were dots by the Congress party where they wanted to connect and show somehow the Hindus were the ones who killed Mr. Hemant Karkare. And okay, it was debated quite long.
Despite
so remember,
all the evidence, yes, in public domain that Hemant Karkare was killed by Pakistani terrorists, the brave Hemant Karkare, along with Ashok Kamte and Vijay Salaskar, brave officers of the Mumbai police, some of whom have had the privilege of knowing personally. We will track the story closely, but just one last word. Let us never, ever fall into a Pakistani trap. A quick break. Up next, we shift focus to the other big story we're tracking here on India Today. Has Prime Minister Narendra Modi's government read out the Riot Act to foreigners who may think they can interfere in Jammu and Kashmir? First, a message to Malaysia, then Turkey, and now to a UK Labour MP when a visa was denied to her. That story and lots more on India First. Stay with us.
Hi everyone, Preeti Chaudhary here. Hope you like this video. For latest news and analysis, like and subscribe to the India Today YouTube channel. And don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated. Thank you for watching.